Today. We commit our team leader in your hands. May you put the words in his mouth that he delivers to the world and to Uganda. The word of hope, the word of courage, the word of wisdom. We thank you, Lord, for this moment. I pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Please take it. All right, once again, you are very welcome. Last week, the Electoral Commission read out to the country what they called an electoral roadmap, which electoral roadmap, as far as we are concerned, is not the kind that is envisaged in Article 1.4 of our Constitution, which prescribes a free and fair election, an election that is participatory, an election that involves Ugandans every step of the way. As the Kenyan Supreme Court, and we can borrow from that, did say, an election is not an event, it's a process. It's a process which begins today. It's a process which goes through the campaigns, the election itself, and then the aftermath of the election, when the proper winner gets to be declared winner and they take over office. And so we have concerns as far as that is concerned. I'm going to invite the principal of the People Power Movement to read to you a statement that highlights our concerns as the People Power Movement. Honorable Chair, you sir.
People power,
our power.
Please resume your seats. Men and women of Uganda, I salute you for staying firm, even at a time like this when our nation is standing on a very shaky ground. Today, we come together yet again when our nation is facing one of the greatest contradictions of our time, the blood of men and women who paid the ultimate price to make sure that there is a restoration of democracy in Uganda is crying out and crying out loud. It continues to call upon the unfulfilled promises, the broken promises and the blatant lies that have been ongoing in our country. We have seen this throughout the 35 years, of blood and tears under the repressive regime of blood and tears under President Museveni. When he moved to remove the age limit from the Constitution and crown himself president for life, it began as a joke. In fact, he initially dismissed it. He denied it in the beginning, but it took only a few weeks before the parliament was raided. Members of parliament were bribed, and some of our people were killed fighting for the survival of the remaining of our constitutional order. Many of the Ugandans, you and I, thought that this was the worst we had seen. Nobody believed that there was any worse anybody would do to stay in power. But now, we all see that a dictator will go to any height and any depth to keep in power. Museveni, like all dictators before him, is determined to keep in power at any cost. He does not care what happens to Uganda or Ugandans, for as long as he he still occupies State House. Fellow Ugandans, I'm reminding you that Museveni is at it once again. He recently met the Electoral Commission and he gave them orders to organize what he called a scientific election. Using the coronavirus as an excuse, he is banning public rallies and other aspects of a normal election as we all know them. I want to tell you that no Ugandan should be fooled into believing that Museveni is doing this for the safety of Ugandans. Because as we speak right now, most urban places are filled with people. No social distancing, no nothing. And if you want to prove the words I'm saying, you go to Chikubo, go to Natete, or go to any urban center that you can reach fast. We have seen normal elections going on, ladies and gentlemen. We've seen them in Malawi, we've seen them in Burundi, and as we speak right now, in America, a place that is much more affected by the COVID-19 pandemic is having elections this year in 2020, and they're having normal elections. In fact, yesterday, the US president was holding a public rally. Therefore, we should not be fooled, and Ugandans should not be taken for fools. As you all recall, ladies and gentlemen, there was no coronavirus when our consultation meetings were stopped. There was no coronavirus when Museveni personally ordered for the blocking of all our shows. So we must all by now be knowing that what Museveni fears are the people and not the COVID-19. He is hiding under the COVID-19 now, just like he was hiding under the Public Order Management Act then. He fears the people. He does not want us to reach the people. Therefore, there is nothing like a scientific election, ladies and gentlemen. For us, what we are going for is a real election. A real election as envisaged by the law of Uganda. A real election as prescribed by the Constitution of Uganda. Ladies and gentlemen, a free and fair election means that everybody who has a right to vote can actually go and vote without being blocked, without being influenced by bribes or intimidation. It means all candidates are given equal opportunity to convey their messages to the voters so that the voters can make an informed choice. I've said this before, and I will say this again, that I, on behalf of the millions of oppressed and exploited Ugandans, will be taking on President Museveni in the forthcoming election, which we expect to be in 6 months. Let me say this again. I, on behalf of the millions of oppressed and exploited Ugandans, will be taking on Museveni in the next presidential election in 2021. Let me also use this opportunity, ladies and gentlemen, to put President Museveni on the notice. Mr. Museveni, you might have forgotten what you said in 1980, but we have not forgotten. You, Museveni, put Obote on notice on the eve of the 1980 election. You said that if Obote rigs the election, you will go to the bush and fight against him. We have come to that point right now, yet again. And we are telling you that you either organize a free and fair election or step down peacefully. I say that again. We are telling you that you either organize a free and fair election or you step down peacefully. But if you continue provoking Ugandans, Ugandans will rise up against you and you will end up in the dustbins of history, like your friend Gaddafi, like your friend Mobutu, and like your friend Omar el-Bashir. So take this as a word from Uganda. Thank you for listening to me, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll say this again in a local language, particularly in Uganda. Thank you.
Basebo ne banyabo abakyala n'abaami ab'ebitiibwa bana Uganda mbasaamu nnyo ekitiibwa era ne mbebaza olw'okusigala nga muli bagumu newankubadde ensi yaffe buli omu akiraba nti kati eyimiridde ku musingi oguli mukankana omusingi ogwayegeyege olwaleero nate era tusinkanye mu kaseera akazibu eggwanga lyaffe ligasimbaganye n'ebimu ku bintu ebitategerekeka mu biseera byaffe ebyobulamu omusaayi gw'abaami n'abakyala abaafa nga balwanirira enfuga ey'eddembe nga balwanira demokulasi ne kaakano gukaaba gutukaabirira nga gubanja ebyo ebisuubizo ebitatuukirizibwa nga gubanja ebintu ebyatugambibwa nga bya bulimba era nga guwakanya obulimba obw'enkuko nadde obubadde era obugenda maaso olwaleero kino tukirabye okumala emyaka egisuka okumala emyaka 3-5 emyaka egy'amaziga n'omusaayi emyaka egy'okunyigirizibwa n'okufuga nga tufugibwa mmundu nga tufugibwa Museveni n'abayeekera be abaawamba eggwanga lyaffe mu 86 era nga bakyatufuga mufuga eyo tunyigiriza Museveni bwe yaleeta olukwe olw'okukyusa ssemateeka okugyawo ekkomo ku myaka abantu bangi baali tebakikkiriza kyali ng'ekyokusaaga in fact naye kennyini yasooka kyegaana n'agamba abo abaali bagamba okugya ekkomo ku myaka baali beewusa baali babuliddwa byakola naye tewaayita wiiki ziwera 3 paliyamenti n'erumbibwa ababaka ba paliyamenti abamu ne bagulirirwa n'abantu baffe bangi ne battibwa era okukakana nga constitution yaffe bamaze okugitaganjula bannayuganda bangi nnyo baali balowooza nti kyekintu ekyo ekisingayo obubi ku bintu ebisobola okubaawo naye njagala obategeeza nti nakyemalira yenna mu nsi abeera mweteefuteefu mbaddiramu nti njagala obategeeza nti nakyemalira yenna mu nsi abeera mweteefuteefu okugenda ku buli levo okulaba ng'asigala mu buyinza era yembeera y'emu pulezidenti Museveni nga bannakyemalira bonna abaamusookawo mweteefuteefu okukola buli kyambyone okukola buli kikolobero okulaba ng'asigala ng'ali mu state house ate nga kino akikola ng'awakanya amaloboozi ag'abantu agoogera ekyenjawulo bannayuganda bannange mwenna Museveni neera kati kyaliko mwenna mwakitegedde nti yayita akakiiko k'ebyokulonda n'akawa ebiragiro n'abagamba bagende bategeke okulonda ku ye kwe yayita scientific election mwakitegedde nti basazeewo okuweera enkuŋŋaana z'abantu n'okuweera byonna byonna oba emitendera gyonna okulonda okw'amazima n'obwenkanya kwe kutambulira nga bwe tukumanyi njagala obategeeza nti tewali munnayuganda yenna alina kukkiriza kusiruwazibwa tewali munnayuganda yenna alina kukkiriza kulimbibwalimbibwa nti kino Museveni akikola kutaasa bulamu bw'abannayuganda muze mukiraba baganda bange weewaawo fenafena tulwanyisa obulwadde fenafena tulwanyisa coronavirus naye tewali muntu yafudde coronavirus mu uganda naye ng'abattibwa abasajja ba Museveni abattiddwa olw'efuga b bangi nnyo kale nno njagala obategeeza nti Museveni kyatya be bantu akimanyi abantu baamukoowa akimanyi talinayo buwagizi mu bantu era akimanyi nti ensi yonna egenda kiraba singa tutuuka mu kampeyini y'ensonga lwaki agezaako okukozesa coronavirus okulemesa abamuvuganya okulemesa ffe abalwanyizi b'eddembe okutuuka mu bantu wetwogerera olunaku lwaleero buli kabugabuga mu uganda kajjudde abantu tewali bya social distancing tewali kintu kyonna oyo awakanya kyenjogerako njagala agendeko mu kibuga olwaleero njagala ogendeko mu kikubo olwaleero njagala ogendeko enateete olwaleero oba genda mu katawuni konna akakuli okumpi amawanga mangi nnyo ago agalina okulonda okugenda maaso omwaka guno 2020 gagenda maaso n'okulonda ng'amateeka bwe gagamba tulabye Malawi nga waliyo okulonda tulabye Burundi nga waliyo okulonda ab'e Tanzania bagenda kulonda mwaka guno n'America ensi esinze okuyisibwa obubi ekirwadde kya COVID-19 bagenda mu kulonda okw'abantu bonna era nejjo President Trump yabadde ku rally ng'ayogera ey'abantu abangi n'olw'ensonga eyo akakiiko k'ebyokulonda akakolera Museveni mwami by'abakama ne banne tebalina kutwala bannayuganda ng'abawumbatuutu tebalina kutwala bannayuganda nga batalina magezi mitwe gyabwe. Ffenna tukijjukira bannange nti tewaliwo coronavirus bwe balemeseza consultation zaffe. Tewaliwo coronavirus Museveni ye kennyini bwe yalagira balemese show zaffe okugenda maaso. Luli yali yekweka mu Public Order Management Act, kakati yekweka mu coronavirus. Kyatya be bantu, kyatya be bantu okumanya amazima n'okwongera maaso okugula amaaso gaabwe. N'olw'ensonga eyo tewagenda kubeerawo kintu kyonna kye bayita scientific election. Ffe kye tugendamu kwe kulonda kwennyini nga bwe kulagirwa mu mateeka okutuuka ku bantu. Nkiddamu nti tewagenda kubeerawo ku ludda lwaffe kye bayita scientific election. Tugenda mu kulonda ng'amateeka bwe googera, okulonda ng'abantu bonna balina okwenyigira mu kulonda. Okulonda okw'amazima n'obwenkanya kitegeeza nti abantu baweereddwa omukisa okuwulira okuva eri abo abakulembeze abaagala babalonde, basobole okusalawo nga bamanyi kye basalawo. Si bino eby'okudongowaza abantu ne bababuzaabuza ne bamala nga babakozesezza okusalawo okwo okutagwanidde okutagenda bayamba. Kino nakyogerako gye buvudde, nzize nkyogera nene guno omukisa kangukozese nago ziremu nkyogere. Ndi nze kamwa koogera ku lw'obukadde n'obukadde bw'abannayuganda abanyigirizibwa. Ngenda kwesimbawo okuvuganya Museveni ate tumuwangule mu okulonda ffe kwe tugendamu kwokulonda okwawandiikibwa mu ssemateeka, okulonda amateeka okulonda okwogerebwako mu mateeka. Naye ate baganda bange kankozese n'omukisa guno President Museveni okumwasanguliza mu lwatu. Mwami Museveni, oyinza okuba nga gwe weerabidde bye wayogera ng'oli ku myaka gyaffe mu mwaka gwa 1980, naye ffe tetwerabidde ssebo. Gwe Museveni wateeka Obote ku notice, walaalika Obote n'omugamba nti singa agezaako n'abba akalulu ka 1980 ogendagenda mu nsiko omulwanyise. Kati emyaka gyekulunguludde giwezaana, tukomyewo mu masanganzira ge gamu. Era twagala okutegeeza ssebo nti oyina emikisa ebiri gyokka. Eitha mutegeke okulonda okw'amazima n'obwenkanya bannayuganda basalewo tukuwangule mu ddembe ogende omule mu ddembe, oba biveeko oritayaringe ove ku ntebe ya bannayuganda. Ekyo bwe kinaakulema ssebo, bannayuganda bajja kusitukiramu beebeereremu, naawe omalirize nga tukusudde mu kasasiro w'ebyafaayo nga kyaliwo Gaddafi, nga kyaliwo Mobutu, nga kyaliwo gwe baakaggyako Omar el Bashir. Bino ebigambo njagala bitwale nga biva mu bannayuganda ate nga babikugamba wakati mukuwa ekitiibwa, naye ate ng'era babikugamba tebakutya kubanga naawe oli munnayuganda. Mwebale nnyo okumpuliriza basebo ne bannyabo, Mukama abeere naawe.
Ssebo tweyanziza tweyanzeege. Naye mwami Museveni yagenda n'ayogera mu ka interview akamu.
Yake egye gyaggwa n'agamba manyi bobanga owezezza emyaka 75. Nina amaanyi oba tokyalina, stamina oba tokyalina. Emyaka egyo gyaluma tewuwe, stamina tekyalina. Kati ayagala atule wali ku TV ku radio akampeyininge kubanga talina busobozi butalaga ggwanga. Era bidde nti ffe tuli bavubuka, amaanyi gaffe tukyalina, eggwanga tugenda ditalaga mu bulungi. I am going to invite a couple of leaders who will be addressing us in a minute, quickly. And then we see how we keep moving. In the minute, quickly, those are the invited. Let me begin with former deputy principal. First, let me invite you in a language you understand better. Nemo Izo.
People power.
Our power.
Okay. Oku, the women of Uganda, the women of Africa, this is our call and this is our fight. In Lubara, what I'm just going to do is emphasize what our president has said. Alo, Amavele Atamba, Robert Chagulani, Ningapaso President Museveni Be, Limu Filipi. Ete koko. Ani, ayo emini, afazi yozuki ni amato koko. Amavele disepi kwa ninga paso Museveni Muzee libera Ese koko. Iri Atamba madisepi Ba amavele pali amende adipi Ba amavele uduku dupini Andro Akini Enzondra Muzee di nili Ili alifu alutororo mikalia rosi
Sio yangu kwenye chisula.
Kinga kiri amabeti, amaveninge nzoda ko. Ani election osku voti beza, bani yoba be oli aliasi, wewe voti be oli aliasi ko. Ba voti be kilili ba paso tu alo. Ale afa mundu tino mbe scientific election da ko agasi, amanga mundu. I see. Balu mask fe iri mere ikake aba mudri ba mask fe iri ikadi fo muambe ani ni vini ngoza mi fe baziliti afada ka ikindera etoki radio million mudri da zengoni ngoni diworo enzoni di enzoni di enzoni agasi ani asopa kirikiri amanga voti bese koko amanga mwati amaki mwenyeze mitetu alo anira muze andera le mamua valiria ba haribe odika rile doninge muni ani aleni saweza angiriko voti amanga vera aleni voti scientific dako alemu voti be idrisi amani ba drazaniku dika le amoto ke amatu alo Amanga paso election di aliara ete koko. Electoral commission ni zima roadmap wini. Nzilani nanida aga roadmap da tesi. Ani, urikoko, asokipa tu alu, atambado mbukwa, dika amaku iselesi, alu alu di woro, la mondo kitubilo duku dite, kini iringa paso ora, asokipa eribe tu alu. Awadifo.
People power.
Tell a gang, the entity to the ambulance, good to have yourself.
Agassi
means
what?
Agassi. Agassi. This Honorable Chifumbi is next to me, and people accuse me of looking like him. Let me invite you, sir, to speak to us in strictly 1 minute.
Agassi. People power.
Our power.
Our power.
People power.
We can only tell the president in no uncertain terms that Uganda as a country, as our principal said, we will not participate in an election that is not conducted as per the law established. That should be understood by everyone. And we call on all forces of change in this country. If there is nothing that can unite us, the quality of our democracy is a unifier. We all have the interest in a free and fair election. Therefore, whether you are DP or FDC or CP or JEMA or any other party, at least we must draw a mark, a line in the sand, and say never again to go for an election which is a ritual.
Agassi.
I think people power and the younger people in this country, we must, as the president has said, we must speak very categorical and clear that we will never accept another president who comes to power, one, by killing us, two, by rigging an election. Museveni is the last president to come to power by killing Ugandans. And is the last president to remain in power by rigging election. Can I repeat?
Yes.
Museveni is the last president to come to power by killing Ugandans. And is the last president to remain in power by rigging elections. Museveni, ye president asembyeyo okujja mu buyinza n'atufuga ng'amaze kututta. Ate era president Museveni ye president asembyeyo okusigala mu buyinza ng'ayita mu kubba obuki
obululu.
Tetwagala mugamba nga people power, tewali kirala tetuli w'abaana baffe na ggwanga lwaffe na bazzukulu tetugenda kubalekera. Omuzungu kyayitiza a heritage. Ng'okutandikawo chapter mpya ky'abakulembeze mu Uganda abalifuga okuva ku Museveni okudda ku Kyagulanyi bagenda kuba tubalonze mu mazima na bwenkanya. Nolwekyo COVID si kiro ekikutte waggulu Museveni ky'alina okweyambisa. Tikyagenda yebambu leero olwaleero gy'agenda okutubika ffenna ng'ensi tusooke tugambe nti olw'okutya COVID America waliyo abalwadde obukadde kati bakawere miliyoni meka, abakafa bawerera ddala emitwalo kati nga kumi n'emeka kumi na munaana. Trump yabadde ne raale wano tetunafiisa na muntu n'omu. Abantu batambula mu matakisi ne mu baasi okuva Arua, okuva e Butambala, okuva e Jinja ne bajja wano balamu. Museveni totya, tekawo akalulu tukakukube n'ebyenda bikwetokota.
Basebo ne baliyabo ekituleese ensonga zoogeddwa. Twagala buyinza mu mazima n'obwenkanya. Ekyo kye tugenda okukola nga tugoberera Constitution ya Uganda. Olwaleero Uganda ne bannayuganda beetaaga okulaba okukyusa obukulembeze obutaliimu kuyiwa musaayi. Kye kigendererwa kyaffe. Tetugenda kukkiriza n'omulundi n'ogumu okutukugira okwogera eri abantu, kubanga abantu beetaaga okulonda omukulembeze nga bategedde ebigendererwa bye, nga bategedde ne byagenda okukola. Tubagamba tujja kubatuukako buli nsonda. Bannamasaka mbagamba wetuli twakkiriza okugoberera Robert Kyagulanyi nga president wa Uganda. Our power.
Weyanziza nnyo nyabo. Ate mwe bannamasaka muli ba mukisa kubanga musajja mujja mulabanga ayitawo. Mukubire kajambo nti muzeeyi weeraba. Agenda awummule alabirire ente ze. Weyanziza nnyabo. Let me invite the Honorable Latif Ssebaggala Ssengendo. Honorable Latif nno ye imamu wa Parliament. Kakati sebo notubulira oba amasinzizo ukyagala okubeera nga magali yao tubulize.
People power.
Our power.
Our power.
People power.
Your Excellency, Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, our distinguished leaders and the press, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
As I've been introduced by our spokesperson, I'm the parliamentary imam. My emphasis is going to be centered on religious institutions. Our motto is for God and my country. There is no any justification whatsoever to continue locking our houses of worship. There is no any justification whatsoever for locking up or continuing to lock up our houses of what?
Worship.
I know, fellow Ugandans, that if they can allow buses to transport people, passengers, for 40 passengers in a bus for 11 hours going to Kisoro or Arua, why can't they allow Sunday services that are conducted in 1 hour? Moscow's on Friday, our maximum is 30 what?
Minutes.
There is no any justification, but the justification is Museveni's what? Justification. It's Museveni who is behind hoodwinking Ugandans that we are fighting COVID, yet it is a political what? Move. We cannot allow, and I'm calling upon our religious leaders, the Interreligious Council. You were so silent. Please wake up. We cannot continue seeing our churches and mosques locked day and night for the last 4 months, and then we just keep quiet. When you go to Chikubo, when you go to Owino, when you go to Parliament, when you go everywhere, what is really that behind locking our houses of what? Worship. I believe that the houses of worship can observe the guidelines more effectively than any other person. I know on Sunday we have church service, we have Sunday services. Most of the churches have two services. They can even say we're going to have four what? Services. Each services that we are supposed to attend maybe 200 what? People. And on Friday, the mosques can also accommodate that if the mosque is full as per the guidelines, then outside there they are ready to pray from anywhere else altogether.
Yes.
Therefore, on behalf of people power and as the parliamentary imam, we are urging President Museveni to open up our houses of worship today, not even tomorrow, immediately.
Altogether.
Secondly, there is no justification for continuing really denying our brothers, the border riders. We know that the most important luggage for the borders are the passengers.
Yes.
If you can allow a bus to carry 40 passengers for 11 hours, why don't you allow a border to carry one passenger for 20 minutes, for 1 hour? What's the justification? So on behalf of people power, we are saying border must carry what?
Passengers.
Because we know we have 1 million borders. 1 million people who are in the border industry. And behind them, they have 9 million to look after. So you cannot deny border access to their basic needs from March up to today. What is the government doing about borders? For us, we are saying borders should be allowed to carry passengers from today. So that they can carry tetujja kusobola kukiriza njogera nga imamu wa parliament ndifa abali masinzizo kubanga bana Uganda moto ya fegamba kulaka tyo na nachi tetusobola kukiriza amasinzizo gaffe amakelezia abakanisa emizikiti jigadwa emyeze na milamba ga jigadwa otuwa songa chi ngokiriza basi stamuza basabaze amakubyana okumala sawa 11 ogenda ekisolo obogenda mwaruwa nega tabaso abagenda okusaba katukanda ku Sunday baina services 2 buli service mala sawa chi sawa emu abone bagenda era mungeri yoku yoku ogero gabati waliwo social distancing baizo gamati kakati tukaenda kwa services nya abantu bibili bibili gabakola chi gabagenda norwecho tukamba amasinzizo emizikiti abakenzi abakanisa tewali nsonga yonna okuja ko ya byabufuzi bino kukulwawo abantu bakola chi abantu basabe basabira kuanga ya fe tufuna akalulu ngasika science akalulu ngakamazibala bwekaja ngabantu bakola chi ekisemba yo boda boda toina kusobola kumatiza aba boda boda bafa emilioni namba bavuzi ba boda boda emabega wabwe baina milioni muenda zebalabilira government evanga yokubalabilira tugamba obugugu ogusoka kuba boda boda mugugu wa musabaze president oli munsi yiyo mbo batwale kago kago yani ngane molo kazatebwa ne taxi zikola chi norwecho tugamba aba boda boda bakirizibwe okutambuza abantu olwalero okugamba ati ebyo gamba ati aba boda boda bagaya kusasaja olwadde ebyo byabufuzi bobo kirize motoka okirize obutale boda boda zikola chi zikuluwewo tutambuza abasabaze kulaka tuwela desi yange bobo nchagulanyi ye president wa fe bila abini mkuru
Sebo imam tuwe anza tuwe anze getu Adete saa leze nkampu katunda zagala nyazi ulira nyo Sese za mudala Alright, so the next people I'm going to invite, let me request that we strictly stick to a minute. Otherwise, then we shall not be able to have you speak because you are running out of time. So what you'll do, you'll speak in one language of your preference in strictly a minute so that we're able to run quickly and get out of this place. The person I'm going to invite next, I love this man. And the reason I love him is, one, he is a card-holding member of the NRM, an MP on the NRM ticket for that matter, but he's interested in change. He says, I am NRM, yes, but I want change. I want a better country also. And we'll encourage you folks out there that whenever you see NRM people, let's not push them away, let's draw them close. Because a number of them are frustrated too, and they want change. Honorable Patrick Nsamba, please speak to us in strictly 1 minute.
People power.
Our power.
Our power.
People power.
People power.
Our power.
Nja kwewola ebigambo bya Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago. Kibane omusajja atujoze nnyo. Museveni atujoze nnyo. Era bannayuganda ejogo lino. Nsaba muliko we buli munnayuganda akowe ki?
Ejogo.
Tosobola kuyita Electoral Commission y'eggwanga mu nnyumba ewuwo. N'obagamba akalumu kateeketeeke bwe muti. Eryo jogo eritasana bannayuganda buli omu waali. Ekintu ekyo kirina okukola ki? Okunyiiza. Bannayuganda baafaayo nnyo wano nga COVID. Ne bafaayo nnyo okukuuma buli kintu, amateeka ne bagakuuma. Bagenda okuzuukukanga kumbe abakulu bali mu jogo. Ensimbi bazibakuŋŋaanyizaako. Ezaakuŋŋaanyizibwa gundi komiti eno zaalagawa bilioni zine bilioni bannayuganda mmanyi ezaalaga ezo zonna zonna tezimanyiddwa kyokka ate waliwo ssente ezaali zirina okukola mu quarter 4 mu institution za gavumenti zonna ezo zonna ssente babbanzi be teri district yazifuna teri ministry yazikola ki yazifuna tebaakoma okwo ne bagenda mu maaso ne beewola bilioniz ne bilioni za ssente zonna zonna babyeki babyenzibe bali mututwala maaso n'okutujooga bannayuganda abatakoowa jogo mwabaaki ejogo likome ejogo likole ki likome ntegeeza bamemba ba NRM bwali eyo ng'owagira ekibiina kya NRM tetukwatangako contract nti Museveni alina tufiirako Contract tetwakwata yali ya kibiina kya byabufuzi ebyo muddako nti Museveni ye NRM ebyo biki bifu abagureeta mubende mbebaza kuba kino mwakitegedde kuba gureeta mubende abawagizi be NRM bangi olwalo nga bawagirawo na Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu era bagureeta mubende Kiboga Kasanda Mityana mwongeze mwa amanyi obulijjo ja singo kujjobulu obuchi obunji kati omulundi guno nafe tugenda kwebereramu tukoye jogo
Let me invite Honorable Kalwanga in 1 minute, one language.
People power,
our power,
people power.
Nga baganda wengogede, ya kongela kensonga, bili, esoka. Tuine chizibu cha amanyi nyo mguanga ino. Nchi abantu baffe, bakulemberwa abantu, abatabamanyi. Mwena abali wano, tambula ogende mu byalo gye tuva. Olabe obaddala waliwo obukakafu nti korona gyali. Abantu bakugamba nti ffe wetuli wano, nebye mwogerako tetukola ki? Naye ekisinga baluma kwe kulya nti twewoze ssente, waliwo ssente ezasondeddwa, waliwo ssente ezatuweereddwa, ne ssente za bajeti ezimu nga zaaliriddwa. Kino kye tusaba. Nga pulezidenti waffe bw'agambye, principal waffe bw'agambye, ffe twagala akalulu akali free and fair. Bino ebyokugamba mu scientific wacha tetwagala kumanya n'omulundi naki n'ogumu tugenda kunoonya akalulu tugenda katambulamu nju ku nju muluka ku muluka LC ku LC President Museveni oyina abakessi bo okuva ku kyalo mpaka ku district bakubuulira amazima enseve mukubonaabona okubonaabona nga twekwese mu kigambibwa nti ye korona kiveewo ensi etambule Tukoye ejogo.
Kumukulembeze nga alimu engeri y'ekivubuka. Bajja kulaga stamina. Ngenda kuyita omukulembeze wa informal sector. Informal sector isinze okunyigirizibwa mu ggwanga lya tulimu. Ate nga ba informal sector Seven in book, but it all garment we want to make a charge to hold in the same.
People power,
our power, people power.
Zoga,
President Museveni, aba informal sector, abagenda mu zoganya buli wamu ona wakola ki?
Wali.
Ekisooka mufunye training emala emyezi esatu gye mumaze mu lockdown. Kibalaze nti musobola okubeerawo nga temuli ku mirimu gyammwe gino ate gyayagala okusazaamu. Tayagala mukomewo okukola. Naye nze ekintu kimu kye mbagamba nti bwe yamaze okukola ekyo nga yaakusazaamu emirimu gya bodaboda aba takisi bonna bonna bakyankalanya. Kati ayagala ateekawo akalulu ka muntu omu. Bw'oleeta scientific election kati ye ne electoral commission baagala bategeka akalulu nga kakeyekka. No need that to scientific election. Twaganye, twamuwadde ennaku nnya, zaaweddeko, katugenda kutandika okuzoganya. Mwena gyemuli, tubakunga, musituke, tulemese enteekateeka electoral commission. Okutuusa ng'etaddewo okulonda. Ate okulonda tugenda kugendamu, nga bwe kwali okuvedda, tugende mu laalo zaffe bulungi nnyo, ffe tumanye okwebeereramu ensonga lwaki situfudde coronavirus. Mwebale nnyo mwebalire dda people power.
Our power.
Chagulanyi oye!
Oye!
Thank you, sir. I'll invite Honorable Sempala Chikosi to speak to us in 1 minute. He speaks very good English, so he'll speak to us in English. By the way, his other name is Sajjali Aveni. You know, Mulavi, that is Sajjali Aveni.
Barua bari wangama ni collect exercise bampite kasajja kaveni ladies and gentlemen Mr. President I just have 2 points in 1 minute one the Kampala metropolitan which is Wakiso and the Kampala and the surrounding areas of Mukono and all those neighborhoods if you get the statistics right You will definitely know that if we win here, the rest is clear. Is that so?
Yes.
So let us be very firm. Let us be very clear. And vote, block, Honorable Chagulanyi, and get the dictatorship out of this country. The president fears one thing. The other day I was on some radio and I told the people, we are going to see a situation, which he fears of course, when Honorable Chagulanyi is in Kajansi, the president is in Makindye-Sabagabo, and there is nobody on his lare, and everybody goes to Kajansi. That is exactly what he fears. And we must be ready, we must not accept the scientific what? Echimala chikolachi. Echimala chikolachi. No going back. Emakere twagambanga nti we either win or they lose. This time we say we either win or he loses. Is that okay?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Mr. President.
Wow.
Thank you. I'll invite Honorable Aisha Kabanda. Aisha used to be RCC for Kampala, and she's interested in change also. Aisha, please come and speak to us in strictly 1 minute.
I salute you, Mr. President. I want to address myself to the women out there. The NRM regime has been a period for the women to suffer. We've suffered toiling for our children to ensure they get a better future. We've educated our children through thick and thin. You all know how expensive education in Uganda is. Unfortunately, NRM has shown us that they don't have a solution to the unemployment problem in the country. Our children have suffered through the informal sector to sustain themselves. Unfortunately, NRM is locking up everywhere. The taxes are too much for them to sustain themselves. The taxes, rather. I want to call upon the women that your children have risen up to fight against Yoweri Kaguta Museveni because they have seen that Uganda is not a good place for them. For us, the mothers, we are still down there sleeping in support of the same man that has denied our children a better living. I want to appeal to you, ladies. Please, let's rise up against this regime. Let's stop fighting the regime that has shown that does not have interest for our children. They don't have interest for the better future. They are here for themselves and them alone. I am here to tell you that the Uganda that President Museveni needs is a Uganda for him and him alone and his family. That's why many of us that supported him came to a time and said enough is enough and left the government. Our children are dying out there. The people, they are killing their children in demonstrations. Our children are demonstrating because they are saying enough is enough. And they kill them. Then one day two, our children are being killed and we are sitting back. Ladies, where are we? Where are we in this trouble? Can we get up and say enough is enough, please? Our child and Jagala Kubasaba, to veyo to Rwane, wamu naba naba fe. Aba naba febala bange chimala chimala. Balwana. But struggling, Feturanyo Kuba Samesa, Naya Uganda Zivunyo, President Museveni, Taina Ansa Kumiri Mujaba Naba Fe. Abana Mukweru and Nako, Awuzika Abata, Abana Beba Taba Mwe, Abana Beba Taba Fe. To Vayo to Yambaba Naba Fetweru and Nako, Abachala, Never Munasigale Mabega, Abana Bafu Deote, Bajakuda Mabega,
yes,
Esina Kuru. Kuwa kubega chako, tuluwana lutalo ngabuchi ali, tuluguse. Kuruwa katona nensi yange, nwana omu na chagula nyi, oba tufa. Ado tutandika lero you people.
Hey,
hey, hey. You
die.
Kuwa na nani boda boda zikole, muzitule ko. Zina tona zila zabarani. Echimala chimala, oruwa lero, msaba katona sasile, chagula nyi, abele present wangawa dako, na mutima nga tukosa mikono, na mimwa, na magulu, temu tamwa, tuluane.
People power. Wow. Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
Thank you, Aisha. Government, where are you? Hey, sorry, ladies, where are you?
Here, here.
All right, I'll take about 3 questions from members of the press, and we shall wrap this up.
We are here. You know, from AFP News Agency, you're saying no to scientific elections. What will happen if the president and the EC continue to run elections? might you boycott the elections or what else would there be? You're saying people should not die anymore.
Like to know more about your plans
to fight it or to rebel it. Thank you very much.
No. Yes, okay. Yes. People will rise. Which is a Mugambi either resign, organize a successful election, or people will uprise and you will go like a Gaddafi. There will be an uprise.
The elector, you have given President Museveni two options: either step down as president or organize a free and fair election. As People Power, what are the options you have if President Museveni adamantly fails to listen to you? Will you also step down from the election, or you will go ahead with a free and fair election, so to say?
Okay, so your hand next to you. It's okay.
Paul Matvis, my name. I work for Record TV Uganda. It has been said that People Power is at an advantage if we went using social media platforms. What are the challenges do you envisage if we went that way during campaigns? Because some people have
that's the only question.
That actually it is cost effective.
Okay. All right, so I guess, okay, we'll have one more.
My name is Tony. My colleague has asked the other question, which I want to ask, but still, can also comment about manufacturing.
Come again.
Manhandling of future man.
You was manhandled. Okay, this will be the final one. Please be loud.
Made a statement. It was one is media owner about the language of the position of being hosted. What is your take on that? Is that
okay. Okay, I'm going to respond to two questions, then I'll invite Honorable Chagulanyi to respond to the harder ones. Charles is asking, the Electoral Commission said they are open to negotiations. Look, this has been our concern from the very start. The Electoral Commission was supposed to have this as a consultative process because there are other stakeholders. What the Electoral Commission did, they went to one stakeholder, Mr. Museveni, who is the potential candidate, and he gave them orders, and now here we are. Okay? So, if they are willing to listen to what we are telling them now. And if they invite us, we shall tell them the same things, okay? But they hope, we hope that they can learn from this. The EC should stop shooting first and aiming later. The consultations should have happened first. You know, you first aim and then you shoot. But nonetheless, we are telling them now, we hope that we shall be able to appeal to their reason and they get to see sense in what we are saying. That all stakeholders, you know, we have aspirants for the presidency. These political entities, political organizations, religious leaders, CSOs, all those are stakeholders who should have been involved in this whole process. That should have happened at the very first step. But nonetheless, we are telling them now, we hope they can get to hear what we are telling them. Paul said that People Power has an advantage over social media. Oh yes, matter of fact, we do. And we are still very tightly holding on to social media. But what we are saying as People Power is that it's not true that every Ugandan is actually